إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حتى آتاه اليقين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، ألا وإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we seek His forgiveness and assistance, and we take refuge in Him from the evils of ourselves and our shortcomings. Whomever Allah guides, there is none to misguide, and whomever Allah leaves to go astray, there is none to guide. We bear witness that there is none worthy of our worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal of the prophets and the final messenger to all humanity. أما بعد، فإن الله تعالى قد خلقنا في هذه الحياة وجعل لنا حقوقا وواجبات. والمشاكل دائما تحصل للإنسان الفرد أو الأسرة أو الجالية أو الجماعة أو حتى الدولة لما تضطرب الأولويات. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us in this life, and for every one of us there are duties and responsibilities, and every time our lives are messed up as individuals or communities or even countries, it is because mostly because our priorities are messed up. ودرسنا في الماضي علم في الفقه اسمه فقه الأولويات. فقه الأولويات، ومن ضمن القواعد التي درسناها على سبيل المثال تقديم دفع المضرة على جلب المصالح. يعني مثلا تقديم زواج الابن المعنت على حج الوالد مثلا، أو قطع الصلاة لإنقاذ حياة إنسان، أو تقديم إنقاذ الغريق مثلا على نصحه للبس الذهب. So we started a long time this science or branch of fiqh, what we call priorities, the fiqh of priorities. And this is found in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So for example, I'm going to give a few examples of the priorities in the life of a Muslim. For example, marrying your son who's not able to wait, if you're not going to marry him this year, he will go to jail or we'll see him in the paper. This takes priority over going for Hajj yourself. You have to marry your son first because he can't wait. Or cutting the salah to save somebody's life. Saving somebody's life takes priority over continuing your salah. You can come back and pray or continue your prayer. Also, saving someone who is drowning is more important than giving them nasiha about wearing gold, for example. So the guy is drowning in the ocean and you leave them there and you want to give them nasiha about wearing the gold. And you recite for them the 15 ahadith in Sahih Bukhari about wearing gold. No, save them first, then give them nasiha. وَدَرَسْنَا أَيْضًا أَنَّ بَعْضِ الْطَاعَاتِ يُقَدَّمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ. فمثلا طاعة الوالدين تقدم على صلاة السنة مثلا. ودرسنا أن بعض المحرمات بعضها أكثر حرمة من بعض، فالكذب على الله كنسبة الولد إليه أكبر من الكذب على الناس. So we started, for example, a long time ago that some ibadat or some acts of worship take priority over others. For example, obeying your parents, doing something for them, is more important than praying Salatul Sunnah after Salat. So you obey them first, buy them something, for example, then you can pray Sunnah. Some muharramat, some forbidden things, are worse than others. So lying about Allah, for example, attributing a son to Him, is worse than lying to the people. وكان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني كان مسألة الأولويات عنده كانت مهمة جدا. يعني تدرس سيرة أو سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فتجد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يراعي مسألة الأولويات. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يتكلم عن ميراث حكمة، وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. So the Prophet ﷺ always prioritized. He looked at the situation he was in and he always exercised this concept of أولويات or prioritized in his life. يعني مثلا في صلح الحديبية وكلنا أعرف القصة وهي موجودة في كتب السير إنه لما جاء سهيل بن عمرو لكتابة الصلح مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأراد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يكتب هذا ما عاهد عليه محمد رسول الله سهيل بن عمرو فقال سهيل بن عمرو لا لو علمتك رسولا لله لما قاتلت اكتب هذا ما عاهد عليه محمد بن عبد الله سهيل بن عمرو وطبعا الصحابة ما عجبهم الوضع ولكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال هذا هو الأصلح فالسلام أفضل والصلح أفضل من التسميات أو التايتلز أو الألقاب. So for example, if you look at the pact of Hudaybiyah, the peace treaty that the Prophet ﷺ signed with the people of Mecca, so at the time of writing the peace treaty, so the Prophet ﷺ wanted to write, this is what Muhammad, the Prophet of God, agreed upon with Suhail ibn Amr. So Suhail ibn Amr protested. So he said, if I knew that you were the Prophet of God, I wouldn't have fought you. We wouldn't be here in the first place. Just write, this is what Muhammad, the son of Abdullah, agreed upon with Suhail, the son of Amr. And the Sahaba were mad. And Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu, wanted to rip off the head of Suhail ibn Amr. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, leave him alone. Signing a peace treaty, living in peace for 10 years is more important than the titles. So that was the priority in the situation. وأيضا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في فتح مكة كما ورد في صحيح البخاري ومسلم حديث الذي روته عائشة رضي الله عنها أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قولوا عليه الصلاة والسلام قال لها لولا أن قومك حديث عهد بجاهلية لهدمت الكعبة وبنيتها على قواعد إبراهيم. So upon the opening of Mecca, the Prophet ﷺ said to Aisha radiallahu anha in the authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim that if your people were still, they have the remnants of Jahiliyyah in them, I would have destroyed the Kaaba and rebuilt it on the foundations of Ibrahim. Because before Islam, the people of Mecca in Jahiliyyah, they wanted to build the Kaaba so they couldn't collect enough funds to build it on the foundations of Ibrahim, so they made it a little bit smaller. So the Prophet ﷺ thought about expanding it, but he said people will not be happy about this, and this is not a priority now, so we'll keep it as is. So that was also a priority. في الحديث الآخر المتفق عليه حديث معاذ بن جبل رضي الله عنه حتى في فقه الدعوة تبدأ بالأولويات. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما أرسل معاذ إلى اليمن حديث متفق عليه لما أرسل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى اليمن قال إنك تأتي قوما أهل كتاب فليكن أول ما تدعوهم إليه شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأني رسول الله فإن قبلوا فأعلمهم أن الله قد افترض عليهم 5 صلوات في اليوم والليلة فإن أطاعوا فأعلمهم أن الله قد افترض عليهم الزكاة تؤخذ من أغنيائهم وترد على فقرائهم واتقي دعوة المظلوم فإنه ليس بينها وبين الله حجاب كما ورد في الحديث. Also in da'wah the Prophet ﷺ always prioritized. So when he sent Mu'adh رضي الله عنه to Yemen to give them da'wah, so the Prophet ﷺ said, you will come upon a people of the book. They were Christians mostly at that time. So he said, when you go to them, priority number one, tell them, teach them that there is only one God and Muhammad is his prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number two, if they accept, priority number two, tell them to pray. If they accept, tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed zakah on them. Take it from the rich, give it to the poor, and be careful, be aware of injustice to people. Because when those who are oppressed, they make dua, then the dua will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala straight. There is no barrier between the dua and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيضا مثلا في مسألة الزواج يعني في الحديث اللي صحيح في الترمذي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول تنكح المرأة لأربع لمالها وحسبها ولجمالها فاظفر بذات الدين تائبة يداك. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جعل الأولوية في الزواج للدين وليس للمال ولا للحسب ولا للنسب. Also, the last example for today, at the time of marriage, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, people are married for four different reasons. People marry a lady or a man, for that matter, for their money or beauty or status, but look for the deen. Deen is the most important thing. And there's nothing wrong in Islam if you marry the most beautiful woman in the world, but she has to have deen. You can marry the richest man in the world, or the man with the fanciest car in the whole city, but he has to have some deen in him, because this is what will last. The money can be lost, the beauty can be lost, the status can be lost, but religion and the deen will always be there. العلماء النفس قسموا مسألة الأولويات أو تصرفنا في الحياة أو الأعمال التي نقوم بها إلى أربعة أقسام. والمشكلة اللي تحصل لنا في الحياة إن إحنا يعني لا نعلم هذه التقسيمات أو مسألة ترتيب الأولويات. فقالوا إن الأمور التي تفعلها في الحياة إما أن تكون مهمة وعاجلة أو ليست عاجلة وليست مهمة أو مهمة وليست عاجلة أو عاجلة وليست مهمة. So the scholars of psychology, sociology, they classified all the actions we do in this life into four things. And always we have problems when we mess up all these categories. So for example, the four categories are important and urgent, not important, not urgent, urgent but not important, important but not urgent. We'll give them four examples. And say, for example, if in one day you have to do four things, pray on time, play video games, study for an exam today, and you'll have the exam in 6 months in the fall, and pay your taxes, and this is the last day. So praying on time is important, and it is urgent. You can't delay it. Playing video games, I know this is bad news for many people. It is not important, it is not urgent. Studying today for an exam that you will have in 6 months in the fall is important but not urgent. You can study today, tomorrow, or next week is not a big deal. Paying your taxes today because it's the last day, it is not important, but it is an emergency. You have to do it. And I don't know of anyone who likes to pay their taxes, okay? But you have to do it or you will go to jail. So it is not important, but it is urgent. When we were at the general body meeting a few weeks ago, we were talking about voting on the constitution. Whether you vote for or against, this is not the issue today, it's up to you. But the direction of the discussion, the importance and the urgency of the talk was directed to changing the organization's name. So I want you to look at the two examples, voting on the constitution and changing the organization's name, and you look at the four categories we mentioned. Changing the name might be important, maybe not, but I don't think it's an emergency. It is not urgent. But voting on the constitution, it is urgent and it is important. And this Sunday, inshallah, if I remember correctly, after dhuhr, they will be voting on the constitution. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وينفعنا بما علمنا نسأل الله الفضل. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله ربه رحمة للعالمين. As we said, the key to your success in this life is to prioritize. Allah has rights on you, your family has rights on you, the community has rights on you, and your body has rights on you. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says in the Sahih Muslim, في حديث سلمان صدق سلمان. So فليعلم كل إنسان أن السر للنجاح في هذه الحياة سواء كنت فردا أو جالية أو أسرة أو مجتمعا هو ترتيب الأولويات. تبدأ بالأول فالأول أو بالأهم ثم المهم. وسبب حصول المشاكل في المجتمعات الإسلامية أو بالنسبة للأسر الإسلامية سببين. السبب الأول هو يعني الاختلاف أو اضطراب الأولويات. So the problem we have in our societies today and our families is because the priorities are messed up. And I'm going to give a few examples, then we'll conclude, inshallah. So, for example, يعني على سبيل المثال لما مسألة تقديم العمل على الصلاة. يعني بعض الناس تظن أن العمل أهم من الصلاة، على أساس أن العمل عبادة والصلاة عبادة، فممكن نشتغل والصلاة مش مهمة، ممكن نصلي يعني قبل ما ننام. أو تقديم مثلاً صلاة التراويح في الفضل والأهمية على الصلوات الخمس. في ناس ما تشوفهاش في المسجد أبداً، أو لا تصلي إلا التراويح، وحتى لو يصلي الصلوات الخمسة بس التراويح عنده مهمة جداً، أهم من أي شيء آخر. أو لما تقدم مثلاً جمال المرأة في الزواج على دينها وتحصل لك مشاكل بعد ذلك وينتهي الأمر بالطلاق، أو أن تقدم الزواج بالكندية اللي هي غير مسلمة على الزواج بالمسلمة لأنها ربما تكون أحسن أو ربما تعطيك جنسية أو كذا، أو تقديم الكسب الحرام لكثرته على المكسب الحلال لقلته، أو الانشغال بجمع الأموال ليل نهار على تربية الأولاد مثلا تربية إسلامية صحيحة، أو الانشغال بتقديم ما نريده على ما نحتاجه، ولا داعي لذكر أمثلة أكثر من ذلك. So most of the time, the problems we have in our lives is mostly because our priorities are messed up. Priority number one is now number 17, and priority number 17 is number one. So you have to put your priorities in order to be successful in this life and in the next. So I'm going to give a few examples and conclude with this. Number one, you will have a problem when working or studying or playing video games is more important than salah on time, because now your priorities are messed up. Some people never pray, nothing. They don't pray any of the five daily prayers, but for them, Salatul Taraweeh is the most important salah in the year. Or Salatul Eid, for example, is more important to them than any of the five daily salah. They don't pray, but when the Eid comes, you see them fighting in the first line to sit next to the Imam, because they love him so much. So you have to put your priorities in order. Also, when marrying a sister or marrying a brother with deen is not as important as marrying someone who is beautiful or someone who has money. You'll always have a problem in the marriage and you'll end up in divorce most of the time. Or marrying a non-Muslim takes priority over marrying Muslim sisters. And I've seen in the past few years many Muslim brothers coming to me to marry a non-Muslim sister, and there's nothing wrong with this Islamically, but in this community or in the Muslim community in general in the West, Muslim brothers can marry Muslim, Christian, and Jewish ladies, but Muslim sisters marry only Muslim brothers. So if all of us marry non-Muslim ladies, who is going to marry our Muslim sisters in the community? And there are hundreds of thousands of them in the West. Who is going to marry them? Also, when you have a job or you deal with the haram because it produces more money than working in the halal because it is little money. So many people do this because they say, if we don't sell pork, man, if we don't sell alcohol, we will not make enough money, man, to buy a fancy car, man. And this is wrong. Al-barakatu fil qaleel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless the little because it's halal. If you give haram money, you become a millionaire from haram, there's no barakah in it. No barakah in your health, no barakah in your family, and no barakah in your children. Also, working day and night to make money and to become rich, when it becomes more important than taking care of your kids and teaching them Islam and bringing them up in an Islamic environment and making them decent Muslims, then we have problems. The last example I want to give before I conclude, we have problems when we put what we want ahead of what we need. And the best example is when we go to Walmart, for example, or the Lucky Store. It's a new store. You go there with a list of 5 items and you end up 30 items. So people confuse what they want with what they need. What you need is 5 items, but what you want is 30 items. You don't need them, but you buy them because it's on sale. You buy them because they look good, but you don't need them anyway. So you keep wasting money, borrowing money from people, and living a miserable life, fighting with your husband to have him buy something he can't afford. So you have to put your priorities in order. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما علمنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينصر إخواننا المسلمين المستضعفين في سوريا وفي كل مكان يظلم فيه المسلمون. اللهم وفق إخواننا المسلمين المستضعفين في مصر. اللهم ولي عليهم من يصلح ومن يصلح، وولي عليهم خيارهم ولا تولي عليهم شررهم، وانصر اللهم إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم وحد دماءهم، ووحد على الحق كلمتهم، واجمع شملهم، واحفظ نساءهم وأطفالهم وأموالهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم عليك بالطغاة الظالمين فإنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم عجل بهلاكهم فإنهم قد طغوا في البلاد وأنثروا فيها الفساد. فصب عليهم يا مولانا سوط عذاب، إنك يا ربنا نبي المنصار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء.